Hey guys, we all know how important getting proper rest is for our well-being. So in this video, I'm gonna share some tips that I hope will help you fall asleep easier and get the best night's sleep ever. One of the biggest culprits of sleeping problems nowadays is staying up on your smartphone or other electronic devices. This is definitely a habit I struggle to break myself. In a perfect world, I would suggest turning off all electronics a couple hours before bedtime to allow yourself to unwind. However, I know that can be difficult. Research has shown that the blue light emitted from our electronic screens delays the release of melatonin, a hormone produced in the evening that tells our body it's time to go to sleep. So the first thing I do when looking at my phone or computer at night is I dim the screen as much as I can to reduce the amount of light in my eyes. Then on my iPhone, I use a setting called Night Shift, which will turn your screen a warmer yellow-toned color to reduce that stimulating blue light. You can also go into your settings and go to Night Shift and schedule the times you want it to turn on and off each night. So I set mine to turn on every day at about the time the sun goes down. Another app I use is this Night Web Browser app. And I love this because if you're browsing the web, you can dim your screen even darker than your phone would normally go. I also do the same for my computer screen. I have this app called Night Screen that allows you to change the color from blue to yellow or orange, dim the amount of light, and also invert the screen colors so you'll have a black screen with white text, and this is so much easier on the eyes when you're reading. Creating the right ambiance in your bedroom can make all the difference when it comes to getting a good night's sleep. Try to keep your space free of excess clutter and mess, and surround yourself with things that you love. Personally, I love salt lamps. I find they create a very calming environment and really help me relax. So a couple of hours before I go to bed, I turn off all my regular lights and then turn on all my salt and crystal lamps. The beautiful amber glow from the salt lamps instantly calms me down. Plus, the salt lamps give off negative ions, which can help improve air quality, leading to a better night's sleep. Studies have found that in general, the optimal temperature for sleep is around 15 to 19 degrees Celsius, or 60 to 67 degrees Fahrenheit. When you sleep, your body's internal temperature drops to its lowest level, so a cooler bedroom can help you fall asleep faster since it mimics your body's natural temperature drop. I personally really love sleeping with the window open in the summertime to let that cool, fresh air come in as I sleep. And I also like to sleep with one leg out of the covers to lower my body temperature. Having a relaxing hot bath or shower an hour or two before bed can also help you sleep. And you might be thinking, huh? You just told me cooler temperatures help me sleep. Well, taking a warm bath or shower will initially raise your body temperature, but when you get out of the tub, your body will begin to cool down, and that'll set you up for a good night's sleep. Also, I love having a shower before bed because it feels so good to jump into bed all nice and clean. And you can use products that have a relaxing aroma. I absolutely love using my Tulsi Rejuvenating Oil with Lavender and Evening Primrose by Apoterra, and my Organic Calming Body Oil by Blue Beautifly. They both have an incredibly calming scent and are a must-have in my evening pamper routine. Another trick that helps me have a good night's sleep as well as a productive morning the next day is to clean up before I go to bed. I cannot sleep well if I have dirty dishes in my sink because then I'll be laying in bed thinking about having to do the dishes in the morning. So I find when you clean before bed, it's easier to relax your mind because you're not thinking about the mess. And another bonus is you'll wake up in the morning to a clean space so you can have a productive start to the day instead of waking up to clean up last night's mess. Next up, drinking a calming cup of herbal tea is a wonderful way to relax and unwind before bed. There's a lot of great bedtime teas out there. You want to look for teas that contain sleep-promoting herbs like valerian root, passion flower, chamomile, lavender, lemon balm, and holy basil. It's like relaxation in a cup. Scent can have a profound effect on our sleep. High-quality essential oils are extremely beneficial when it comes to calming down and falling asleep. Some of the best essential oils for sleep are lavender, Roman chamomile, vetiver, sandalwood, vanilla, marjoram, and spikenard. Two of my all-time favorite essential oil products to use for sleep and relaxation are the Living Libations Bedtime Story Diffuser Blend and the Living Libations Sweet Sleep Serum. The Bedtime Story Diffuser Blend contains chamomile, lavender, tangerine, and spikenard. And I put a few drops into my diffuser a few hours before I plan on going to bed, and it just fills my room with its calming aroma. And then you can just apply your sweet sleep serum to your pulse points. My whole family uses this and absolutely loves it. And of course, I have to mention my favorite sleep-promoting crystals. You can sleep with a little gem under your pillow, hold one in your hand, or just place them beside your bed. Some common crystal choices for sleep are rose quartz, lepidolite, amethyst, lithium quartz, danbrite, selenite, and more. The more positive energy in your bedroom, the better night's sleep you'll get. Flower essences are another wonderful tool for promoting rest and relaxation. They work on an energetic level to help positively transform your mood and your mind. For sleep, I love Lotus Way's Quiet Mind and Inner Peace line. Quiet Mind is my personal favorite. Use the flower essence elixirs under your tongue, massage the anointing oil into your pulse points. I love applying it to my wrists so I can smell it as I go to sleep. And then just spray your pillow and face with the mists. Using my flower essences is one of my favorite parts of going to sleep. Sleeping in a dark, quiet room is very important for a good night's sleep, and wearing a sleep mask can make all the difference. Darkness triggers your body to produce melatonin, a hormone that makes you feel sleepy, so a sleep mask will shut out the light and make you fall asleep faster and stay asleep throughout the night. And you can even get sleep masks that are filled with lavender. If you're dealing with any annoying noises, you can wear some earplugs to bed to block out the sound. However, I wouldn't wear them every night. I only wear earplugs as a last resort. So yes, certain sounds can keep you up all night, but there's actually certain sounds that can help you fall asleep as well. So if you prefer not to sleep in total silence, I have some wonderful sound and music suggestions to help you sleep. The soothing sounds of nature are perfect to listen to while you fall asleep. I love listening to ocean waves crashing. The sound of the river. The sound of rain. Healing instruments like singing bowls. And if you prefer music, I suggest you listen to something calming like classical or meditation music. Also, ASMR videos can be quite relaxing to watch before bed. You can even try experimenting with white noise, pink noise, and brown noise. These are sound signals which can help mask background sounds that might prevent you from sleeping. They're basically a constant, unchanging noise. There's white noise apps and YouTube videos that you can use, but a lot of people simply use a fan or air conditioning to get the same effect. And while you're laying there listening to your nature sounds, you can do some visualization exercises. Visualize a scene or story that you find relaxing. I love to imagine myself at the ocean with the sand between my toes and the salty warm air against my skin. Your attention will be so focused on the details of the scene that you'll eventually forget about your worries. And if you're still laying there restless in bed, you can also do a technique called progressive muscle relaxation, where you will tense and then relax all the muscles in your body. You'll focus on each muscle group in your body, tensing specific muscles for a few seconds, and then slowly relaxing them. And remember to breathe deeply as you do this. Start with your toes and work your way up your entire body all the way up to your forehead. When you're done, you'll feel so much more relaxed. We spend a lot of time in our bed sleeping, so I suggest you invest in some comfortable pajamas and bedding to allow yourself to have a comfortable night's sleep. I don't like sleeping in full-length pajamas or socks, so I like to wear shorts and a tank top or t-shirt to bed. Make sure your mattress is comfortable and your bedding is breathable. And if you have long hair, put your hair in a comfortable hairstyle before bed. I really like going to sleep with a braid in my hair. A weighted blanket is a great option to help with sleep and anxiety issues. The weight of the blanket acts as deep touch pressure therapy and causes the brain to increase serotonin production and relax the nervous system. Some individuals may not like the extra weight, however, I personally love it and think it feels like a big hug. Exercising during the day will help tire you out, and it helps reduce stress by releasing endorphins. If I'm not active throughout the day, I notice it's a lot harder for me to fall asleep at night. Even just walking around outside a bit and enjoying the fresh air can help, but you will want to avoid vigorous activity right before bed, as that can actually give you a burst of energy, and we don't want that. Doing a bit of bedtime yoga to help you unwind can work wonders. Try doing gentle restorative poses. Yoga is wonderful because it connects us to our breath, which leads us into my next tip, deep breathing for a restful sleep. Focusing on your breath is extremely powerful. It calms the mind and tells your nervous system that everything's okay. So lay in your bed and breathe your worries away. Our minds are incredibly powerful, so try your best to replace your racing thoughts with calming, positive affirmations. Here I've written down some examples of sleep-promoting affirmations. Remember to make them present tense and always keep them positive. You can say them yourself or listen to them in an audio recording. The affirmations will become more and more real the more often you practice them. What you eat and drink before bed can make a huge difference on your sleep. You'll want to avoid having a large meal right before bed and avoid caffeine and other stimulants in the afternoon and evening. Try to instead reach for a light snack before bed. Magnesium-rich foods are great for sleep, and I often take a magnesium supplement before bed. And finally, some other tips for a good night's sleep are try to go to bed and get up at the same time every day. Avoid sleeping in too late. Avoid napping in the day or keep it under 30 minutes. Go to sleep on a happy note. Don't watch something depressing or disturbing before bed. I like to watch something happy and inspiring before I go to sleep. Don't go to bed mad at a loved one. Keep your bed exclusively for sleep and try other holistic remedies and therapies to help you sleep. Emotional freedom technique where you tap yourself is supposed to be a really good one. So those are some of my tips to promote a restful night's sleep. Sometimes even the smallest changes in your lifestyle can make a big difference on the quality of your sleep. I hope you all have sweet dreams tonight. I love you, and I will see you in my next video. Good night.